down, riding all these highs, waiting for the calm down. Walk these streets with me, I'm doing decently, just glad that I can breathe.
Please check out our shirt on Teespring.
Hey folks, what's happening? What's going on, little world? Little curious, not too nosy. I'm going to talk about this movie that you can watch on Hulu. It is labeled a supernatural horror movie, and it's called Cheaper's Creeper Reborn. It came out in 2022. So the director of this movie is Timo Vuorensola. This is a North American debut directing. This is a remake of Victor Salva's. He directed and wrote three of them, but this one he had no influence at all, and I think they kind of stole it from him. So pretty much Creeper's thing is every 23 days he's out and hunts for parts of bodies, and he likes something about you, he'll take it from you by force. So the movie stars a young couple driving somewhere in Louisiana. They're going to kind of cosplay. The girlfriend's not really into it, but she's in love, trying to make her boyfriend happy. So you learn two things about the couple. The boyfriend later on is trying to, you know, pose to her. He doesn't know that she's pregnant yet. So some reason they have a hard time trying to locate the hotel and the festival. So they go by this fortune teller place or antique store and get directions, and turns out that I paid for the map for $50, and turns out it's a kind of trap to help the cheaper creeper find victims. And when the couple came in, turned out she was pregnant. I guess some reason they're looking for a pregnant victim for him for some reason. So pretty much you learn that there is some kind of secret society is helping the cheaper creeper find victims, and I guess the post play party is trying to find the right ones. So the funny part about the movie of the hotel, the boyfriend talks to the girlfriend to wearing these bunch of different cosplay costumes, you know, kind of sexy outfits. And she wears like, you know, four different outfits, you know, trying to say, hey, you know, wait, think of this, you know, sexy Freddy, the sexy Harley Quinn, and stuff like that. And then later on they arrive at the cosplay thing. It occurs at a random, the couples win a contest to spend the night at the creeper's house. And as well, the craziness happen, you know, makes it more fun. Before I say anything about this movie, I like, you know, I like the little trivia they do for the ensemble mystery of it. What people think they got the idea for this movie. A little history of the killer who killed his wife and did some awful things to her. Of course, Victor, the creator of Cheaper's Creeper, denies he got this idea from this. So this is my thoughts of it. For, they have more budget on the first one, but this one, but it didn't have the magic of the first one. And I say the last two were good, but the first one was excellent storyline. You can tell low budget movies. It had everything that you like about a movie. You know, good dialogue, good characters. This one, it was just too slow pacing. You just didn't really care about it. The characters didn't really seem to be real or overacting. Of course, the acting was not great in this movie. It's not really worth seeing it. I mean, you like crappy horror movies, it's the one. It's on Hulu, watch it. You know, that's the only good thing I have to say about it. There's some good killing scenes. It would be a lot better if they didn't go to the house and get chased by them. If be more interesting the creeper just stayed at the cosplay thing and starts killing people, that'd be a much better movie. But all the rest, it just got really stupid, in my opinion. You just pray for the end. You pray about just get killed and that'd be the end of it. But that's my thing of it. So that's my thing. Like and subscribe, maybe do better next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.